You've seen the Elvis comeback special, right? From 1968.
From 68, yeah.
Where the part where he's in a leather suit. And
oh yeah.
Around with
yeah.
all his sycophants.
Yeah.
And,
oh, you mean
all laughing at his non-story?
You mean when he's up on the thing and he goes I remember a thing.
Yeah.
The guy's 20 yeah. years older than him.
Yeah.
The guy drumming on the guitar
exactly.
case.
Yeah.
Those are the Jordanaires.
Why did that happen? They couldn't get this guy some kind of drum or some. He's drumming on a guitar case. It's a TV show.
Yeah, yeah. And the other thing is, the thing everybody remembers that part of the thing. If you watch that whole special, it's one of it's got these gigantic dance numbers that are enormous. It's got this 18-minute version of the song Guitar Man. And it's endless. It just keeps going through the dance thing, and it's boom, it's got horns going crazy, and it's there's a ragtime saloon. There's everything. It's everybody's oh, Elvis was back to his roots. No, for that one segment he was. The other thing was just as hokey as every one of those dumb movies was doing.
Yeah. Well, that was back then. In those days, they would have those variety shows where they would film on broadcast live from these gigantic sound stages.
Yeah, yeah.
And they would have these elaborate sets for these dumb sketches and stuff. And the sketches were so long, there'd be a commercial break in the middle of it.
Well, yeah, what? It's not better for a sketch than we'll be right back.
Yeah.
That is hilarious.
After these words from Colgate, and then you come back and wait, who are these people again?
Yeah, exactly. Doing the skit. And those are not sketches. Those are skits.
They're skits. The longest skits ever produced.
And I will say, I love that Elvis 68 comeback thing. I went down to Graceland. I looked at that suit. I stared at the leather suit and the thing. Stared at the white suit.
Yeah, that's right. The white suit was pretty cool.
The white suit
It does not get a lot of mentions, but it was a very cool suit.
Everybody talked about the leather thing with the wristbands he wore. Like the leather wristbands. They were in Graceland. You know where those suits were? There's so much stuff to show at Graceland. They have those suits in a gift shop. We're walking around Graceland. We walked on the plane. I'm telling you, the one plane. If you go to Graceland, first of all, it is the greatest thing you will ever see in your life. It is so awesome. Yeah. Because you know why? You go in this guy's house, and you realize this is just some dude with a house.
Right.
It's a nice house.
Right.
It's just a house, though. There's McMansions that are bigger than this place. This dude bought some property in Memphis, wanted to be close to the action, lived in town. It's actually kind of like the dream, where it's hey, I'm from this town. I'm not going to live outside of town. I'm going to buy property right in town and build a giant house in the middle of the town, the city. And then I'm going to ride my motorcycle all around the city. And then you go in this guy's house, you realize, this is just some dude who wanted to hang out, had a cool rec room downstairs. Nothing too crazy. The craziest thing is he's got three TVs. He realized he has three TVs in the rec room playing the three channels at that point.
Oh, what?
Yeah.
The height of decadence.
Yeah, exactly. Can you believe how crazy Elvis, if Elvis was doing it now, he'd be he'd be going for the 54-inch flat screen TV. Comparable decadence-wise.
I have to say, for a crazy pillhead, he showed admirable restraint.
Yeah. You know what?
I think that all came from the colonel, where he's Elvis, look, don't go, just get a nice house. You don't have to get a crazy mansion. Just get a nice house. Was that all in service of him keeping more money?
I'm going to say I don't think the colonel was, first of all, this guy's calling himself the colonel.
Uh-huh.
I'm going to say, this is the dude who was hey, Elvis, you can't play outside of America. Why? Because the colonel couldn't leave America. That's why.
Right.
Like, you don't want to play Europe.
Convince him it was a bad idea.
Yeah.
Like, oh, you don't want to go there.
Yeah, you don't want to play England. Why would you play London, Elvis?
They'll make fun of you.
Yeah. Exactly. Meanwhile, you're, okay.
Because you're just simple country folk.
Yeah. But I'm telling you, you go to Graceland, you go on the jet, like they have the two planes. The one plane, it is literally one of the coolest things you will ever see in your life walking through that plane. When you realize this guy had a house with wings, basically, like a cool apartment with wings, like this crazy bed in the back. Oh my God, I could only imagine flying on that thing. But it's like Elvis. And then you go to this thing and you realize, oh, this was just a normal dude who, and you realize it's like for the first time that he's like a person. And then you go in the gift shop and you're like, oh, they're not treating him like a person in their own gift shop for the place. It's like bobbleheads and like weird just jigsaw puzzles and like turning the songs like hound dog stuff. It's like, no, you're like, you actually lose sight that they're actual records. Actually made a record, and it was dangerous at one point.
Yeah.
It was like, and it just shows you, anything in America that is scary will not be scary at a point. Like, if there is somebody in the culture who is scaring everybody, just wait a little bit. They will not be scary very soon.
Yeah, that's what happens when you succeed in changing the world, is that people get used to it.
Yes. Yes. People get, exactly. People just, they adjust to it. And then you are just a part of the fabric.
Yeah. Because people, they accept certain things. Like, there was enough people that accepted what Elvis was doing. They said, no, we would like this to continue. But like a guy like Hitler, not enough people were on board. Not enough people said, yeah, this is great. There was enough people that said, this is bad, and we should stop this kind of world changing.
Let's,
Tom, I want to talk more about Hitler.
Are you still teaching that history class? You're like Robert Wool.
Exactly. That's exactly right.
You know, a lot of people look at the thing. You got to see here. This is what Benjamin Franklin was up to. This is what Benjamin Franklin was up to.
Over here, you got Thomas Jefferson. People don't want to hear what he does today. He's still with the slaves. And then
For people who don't know what we're making fun of, there's a thing on HBO that Robert Wall hosts where he's like teaching a class of extras. he's doing his version of history.
Lesson. Yeah. Funny history lesson.
Yeah. Professor Wall.
Oh, wait. So my point about the Elvis thing was, in bringing that up, that when he's sitting there in the leather suit and everything, and he's saying, you know, he's answering questions that nobody seems to be asking. Like, Elvis is bringing up these questions. Like, a lot of people ask me, what do you think of the new groups that are out there? And, you know, I like a lot of them. I like the Beatles. I like the Bears. I don't know. I have no idea who the Bears are.
I think he's trying to say the Birds.
Is that what it is?
I think he's talking about the Birds.
Because, man, 1968, and the Beatles are still a new group. They had, in 4 years, from February 1964, they appeared on the Ed Sullivan Show.
Yeah.
From then on, like, they were dictating what pop music was.
Yes.
They were in charge of it. They were inventing it. And then 1968, the Beatles, the Bears.
The Bears.
New groups like that.
Well, you know what? That was a turf war with this dude. It's a turf war.
Of course. And they met him and were disappointed because he was on pills.
Yes. Elvis, though, go to Graceland. You should go to Graceland.
I would like to go to Graceland. You have made the best case for it out of anybody that's ever told me. Because I've been to Memphis a couple times. I had no desire to go to Graceland.
Oh, I'm telling you, go to it, and this is the thing that gets you. You walk through this thing. Here's one of the things that this struck me. First of all, this explains the entertainment industry in a nutshell. If anybody needs to know how it works and why, if people want to know why their favorite actors do crummy movies to get as much money as they possibly can, every once in a while. This is why. There's one time you're walking through this thing. Elvis was on RCA Records. I took a picture of this. I should put it online, where it's a picture of a... In his hall, there's this hall of awards, all the gold records and all the movie posters and everything. And there's this one thing where it's a television set, like a console TV, and there's a plaque on top of it that says, given to Elvis Presley by RCA for sales of 50 million records. So RCA managed to cough up a TV that they made because this guy moved 50 million records for them. That's how the entertainment industry works. You sell 50 million records, they'll send you a TV that they made to say thank you.
That they had lying around.
Yeah, that cost them $4.
No special effort was made in any way.
Yeah, it's not even like it was something that they just like, let's get him a console TV. It's like, no, let's get him a console TV that we assembled at cost. Like,
and it's not going to be personalized in any way.
Yeah, no.
It's not going to be like some sort of leopard print TV that goes in the jungle room.
No. 50 for sales of 50 million units. 50 million!
Even if those records were a penny each, that is still an impressive amount.
Yes, exactly. A TV! That's what they gave him. So, but you go through this, you look at that, you look at the stuff. There's this one thing where you see him give this speech that he wrote for this, like, I think it was like a, I forget what the thing was in 1972. He wrote this, like, heartfelt speech. It was very nice. You go through it. You're starting to have an understanding of this guy, and then you see his, like, he had, like, an indoor racquetball court and stuff like that. And then all of a sudden you step out the thing, and there he is, his grave.
Oh,
on
boy.
The property, and all of a sudden you're like, oh my God, and it just hits you all of a sudden. You're like, oh my God, that's where he's buried.
Yeah.
Like, you forget that he's buried at Graceland next to his mother and father.
Now, is that what you want?
Is that what I want?
Yeah. Would you like to be buried in your own backyard?
Sure.
You got a nice house?
Sure. Why not? I want to be buried here at WFMU.
You want to be buried or you will be buried?
I probably will be. Will be.
Yeah. Yeah. That's an important distinction.
There must be lights burning brighter somewhere. Got to be birds flying higher in a sky more blue. If I can dream of a better land where all my brothers walk hand.